Hey, Fitzy here, back at it again with another one. Back at the Mustang. I want to get some work done on it now and get the interior back in it. Get the steering column put in it. Get the brake pedals, brake booster, get all that back in it. Get the wiring put back in it. Get the front end put back together in it and finish off that rack and pinion steering. Don't worry, there is some fabrication at the end of it. I'm going to show you how to make some little homemade brake line clips. So, stick around. Before we get started, a few have been asking for updates on cars. Where I'm here at the Mustang, I'm trying to get this car finished up. I may be boring to some of you guys. There's no heavy fabrication involved in it and whatnot, but I got to get this car finished. The goal is to get this car done first, and then I want to get at this one here. The Toyota's on hold now till this is clued up. So I just wanted to let you guys know that it's still here. I have a bunch of metal work. There'll be lots of videos coming on it. But I want to finish the Mustang first. I've been picking up a lot of material for it. I have over here along the wall. I picked up all the steel for the chassis and the roll cage. I have that there. I picked up some engine parts. I do have a turbo now. In here. I'll show you that at a later date. Right? But I have picked up a bunch of stuff for the car. I've been still buying pieces and parts for it and picking up what I can around so I can, when I get time to go at it, it'll have it all there. So I'm just letting you know that I'm still going to be at this. It's just that for now, until I get this one done, this is going to be on hold. I can only do one car at a time. That's customer's car. I got to get the metalwork finished up on that. So a few of you have asked me if that is mine or not. It's not. It's a Blondo customer. I own this little puppy here. And this is Wendy's car. And of course that one. That one there is going to be long term. Won't be at that for a while. A few of you have asked about patches. I got him out in the patina bay. Here he is here. Okay. I'll be getting back at patches. I'm still doing the truck. I put it out here so it can rust, because that's the look I'm going after once they finished everything off on it. I just want to give a quick little update on it. It's still in the works. I have it on hold for now because, again, the Mustang. I got too much stuff kicking around, too many projects, and I'm trying to clue up one before I start bringing other ones in. Once the Mustang goes out, this will be coming in, and I'll be working back and forth between this and the Toyota to get things done. I want to finish this truck off. I have everything to finish the body on this truck now. Fenders, hoods, grills, box, rear fenders. Only thing I haven't got is a tailgate, which I intend to make. And I'm building a chassis for it. I have a Ranger chassis out back that I'm going to be putting underneath it. So stay tuned. I'll be getting back to this one eventually. But for now, I want to get that Mustang clued up. All right, it's time to get back in the Mustang. My whole goal and plan is here now is I got a bunch of firewall, boosters, steering column, rack and pinion. There's a bunch of stuff there I want to get in place because I want to get the brake lines ran, get the steering all figured out. You haven't seen a video on that. That's a Cavalier rack and pinion. I've done a full couple of videos on installing that on a 66 Mustang. Check it out. I got everything cleaned up that was original to the car. This is a Granada booster and a brand new master cylinder for Granada, 78 Granada. That's what I had on it. I'm replacing all the brakes on it. The booster was still good, but the master cylinder was old, so I replaced that. I cleaned everything up, never got carried away with it, nothing sandblasted. Everything is just, cleaned up by hands best you can. There's the piece underneath the dash that holds everything in place, the brake pedals and whatever. There's the brake pedals that are fully modified. I modified them to fit Wendy. She's short and got small feet, so they were pretty high off the floor. They were custom made, and so I went and modified them to fit her. Same with the gas pedal. That's been modified as well. I've done videos on that. And two of them, that's just a regular GM gas pedal. Everything is just painted, with just rust touch, Krylon, satin black. I like satin black on everything. I got the everything cleaned up over here. Things get dusty here now. We're in the shop and I've been doing work here. So things, I just cleaned up that corner there. Over here now, I got, I went through a lot of the interior back in it. Rear panels, rear seats. I got to make a deck panel for it. Got the door handles put on it. I had the front carpet and everything put on it, but I took it all out. I had to get up underneath the bottom over there and paint everything up. So, get everything cleaned up. I wants to get all the dash back in it. As you can see, I got the dash pad laid in place. It's the wrong color. It almost looks purple. So that's got to be painted. That's a brand new dash pad we picked up for it. But I wants to get all the mechanics of it. The booster, the steering column. What else is it? The gas pedal and the brake pedal. All that figured out and back in the car. All that's been in the car already and it's all running pre-fit. I just had to detail it and put it all back together. So that's pretty well straightforward. The steering column's right there hung on the beam. So that'll be going in it as well. So I'm just going to set up the camera there now and start bolting all this back together. And take you along for a bit of assembly. Well, I got a lot of stuff put in there. Got steering column, all the dash put back together. I got all the wiring ran. I had to hook up the courtesy lights. Run that new switch for the heater box. And what else was that? I had to put another cable on it for the heater controls. One of them was broke. Install the brake pedal and gas pedal. What else did I do over this in here? And all that done, and then I went out here, then I went ahead and ran all the wiring. I gotta get hangers now to hang this stuff up on the in their fender wells and whatever. But I got it all run. I got the heater all hooked up. I got some new heater hose put in. Hopefully that's long enough. If not, I'm gonna join into it. I got all the starter wires, or alternator wires, sorry, and the solenoid wires. Starter wires are over there. Or down there, sorry. Yep, down there. And I got the brake booster on there. So next thing now is for me is to install a rack in there. That'll be next thing. The wiring is pretty well clued up. I haven't put the dash or nothing in it yet because I'm waiting. I got to paint the dash pad. And in order to, before I put this cluster in, I got to put bolts and everything in there so I can get my hands in around. So I want to get all that done. The dash pad and everything on it before I turns around and does that. Same with the glove box. I got a new glove box here to put in it. I can't put the kick panels on it. I got to order a couple of these little switches for the courtesy lights. Or speaker wires hanging down there for the speakers in the back. You may think that, okay, we're just bolting this back together. I've done a lot of this over the years, and I can tell you, bolting a car back together, it's never as easy as it is. That brake pedal assembly I had in out of this car 5-6 times because I modified it for Wendy, and I just put that in there just then, and I was at it 15 minutes. It would not go in place. It was just like, it was just being stubborn. Everything I tried, it wouldn't go in place. It was bringing up, it was busting clips. It was, you know, it was weird what was going on. I had to get away from it. But you think that once you got everything done and fitted, and then you start bolting the car together, it's gonna go snap, 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 snap. Trust me, it never does. The steering column was trouble putting in. The bolts, the studs here were all giving me troubles. So it's just all a part of it. You think you can actually bolt something together and, okay, that fits now. So when it takes it apart and paints, it's going to fit perfect. Take my advice from this. I have many years experience of this. It's never the case. Anyway, I'm going to get back at it now and get the rack and everything in it. So it's more work done. Well, I got that bolted in. It bolted right in. That was the best kind. And I went ahead in and put the universals and everything, got that all rigged up. If you're not familiar with what I got down here, it's a Cavalier rack. I got it modified to fit in the Mustang, and I made all this up and made up all the bracket trees. I done a full video on this and an earlier video on this Mustang. If you want to check it out. I've been waiting on parts, and the parts came in, and this is what I got. This is all the gear from a Cavalier, the outer stuff. The way these works is, this is the two bars here, this one and this one is for the a Cavalier, but I noticed that this one had a bend in it. So what I went and did is I ordered two of these so they were straight, and that's the two of them there. And then I ordered the bracket kit to bolt down in the center. And I went and brought these in because they were dirt cheap. I don't know if I'm going to use them or not. I don't think I will be. And I also brought in two little rod end pieces, the adjusters here. I brought them in as well. I said, you know, it'd be good to have them there. I might be able to use them. And if not, I'll use them for something in the future. So, and this came with bushings. I won't need these because there's new bushings in all these. So I won't need them. So I'm going to fit these up in the car now and see what we got and start sizing things up. Figured before it goes too far, I'll run over. I'm pretty well got this all clued up here now. And I'm going to run over what I did and what I changed to make it better. If you're not familiar with this video on the front rack and pinion, I'll have a link in the description about the setting up of this rack. In the last video I had on this here, I talked about raising. This is the point here where you would mount these here. These would be mounted on the rack and pinion about right here, okay? And I figured out by moving it up 1 inch, I could shorten the outer ends of them out here. I could shorten up the bar where it goes onto the knuckle. So I started to play around with it some more, and I raised it up 1 inch. But what I ended up doing, I raised it up 2 inches, okay? That point, I raised it up. So now this is going to mount here. This is bolted onto the rack, and then these rod ends will bolt on here. By doing so, I come to realize that on the tie rod ends, the factory Mustang tie rod end, the point is about here, and the center line goes through here. It's about 3/4 of an inch from where the bottom of the knuckle is to and right here. And I think I had 2 inches, or no, 1 3/4 inches I had. I had measured up that I needed to have the space around the bottom. Now this here was 3/4 of an inch, so I needed another full inch. Okay, and I was trying to see if I could use these. So this is what I come up with, okay? What I have here, this is the original Mustang tie rod ends as the outers. This is the remains of the inners. What I did is I cut the sleeves off them, the end of it off, which is this piece here, okay? I took the tie rod end and I cut that off, which this is the way this originally was like so. This was on the end of that there. So what I went and did then is I cut the two of them off. And I took the original Mustang inner tie rod and sleeve and the Cavalier piece. And I turned around and I welded the two of them together right here. How I did that is I turned around and I beveled the ends of it like this. This is how you do it, right? I beveled the ends of it. So then when you put the two pieces together, you had a nice gap. And then I welded it around a few times to give it strength. Now, I didn't just want to leave it there, okay? Just have that end welded on the end of the piece, because that's what's done here, and then I grind and dress it. It's welded in this area here. You probably see it a bit here, right? That's where it's welded through. What I did then is I went out and I have an old Dodge. This is the center link. I have an old Dodge truck. That's 1/8 of an inch thick. Okay? I went and cut pieces out of that and made these little sleeves. Okay? Now I drilled holes in them. They're plug welds. I staggered them because I didn't want the plug welds opposite to each other. And I put one here and two on this side here. And what I did then is I took that and I slid that down over this here. And then I welded it on. And this is what I come up with. So now I got double the strength here. So it's welded here and it's got a few plug welds in it. And then inside this here, two of these are welded together. So there's lots of strength there for it to be, you know, for that to work and everything. And there was lots of heat and everything in it. So now I have a Cavalier inner tie rod end that has the threads on the outside that could take this sleeve. So now I can put all this together here and make a full tie rod setup. I've already went and checked it on the car and I ran it through the motions, and it was only, I think, in 6 inches of travel from zero to ride height to 2 inches above. I think it was like 1 3/4 inches total bump steer, which is what the factory was. So I'm very pleased with it. It worked. I was amazed. And the key was when I moved these up. When I moved this section here up, it changed the geometry out here on the end and made this distance smaller again, right? So I just wanted to show you that before I went ahead and finished off this one here. If you're a bit lost here, you're going to have to go back and check out that other video and go through the motions of what I've done for the rack and pinion. That I'm going to get this all finished up here now, welded up, and I'm going to get it all put back together again. I'll show you what it looks like. Now I had the rack all back in, the rod ends and everything. I got them all bolted up, mounted where they got to be, and they're all set up there, as you can see. Now I've been playing around with just double checking, making everything. Now I do not have the coil springs in the front of this car right now. There's nothing in there. I done that for this particular reason because I wanted to run this through the motions. And I got the jack, as you can see, set up there. on a cross member, and I got this set up at ride height, which is roughly 26 inches to the bottom of the fender, to the floor. That's what I went and did. And so what I went and did then is I ran it through the motions. I ran it up and down. So I'll actually just show you what I got done here, so you can actually see what's going on. This is all I got done with no springs in the car. You can actually lower the car down. I can jack the car right up. When I jacks it way up, you see the tire turns in a small bit. That's at 29 inches. That would be under acceleration, okay? That is 1, 2, 3 inches above ride height, which I have no intentions of really going that crazy with it. So I set it up at 2 inches above, which is right here, 28. That 28 there. That will be 2 inches above ride height. Bit more. And that's 26, roughly about 26 there. That would be ride height. And so say now you're driving down the road, you hit the brakes and you're stopping at a light. This is where it'll happen. She'll nose dive on you. And this is where she'll be at 24. Right? Now, if you noticed, I'll show you, I'll run you through the motions. There's very little movement from 24 inch or 26 inches to 24 inches, toe in or toe out. I think it might be an eighth of an inch, if that. But from 26 to 28, there is about an inch of toe in. Now that's normal on a lot of vehicles to have so much bump steer on a car. In the case of what I'm putting together here, this is not a drag car, so I'm not really concerned about acceleration. I'm more concerned about deceleration when she's driving the car. So I'm very happy with the whole setup. It's going to work out good. So I'm just going to button everything up, get springs back in it now. And I'm just going to show you the frontal view now of this. All you got to do is just watch this distance right here on the ring, and you'll watch that grow and small. Right now, she's at her bottom point. That'd be deceleration. I'll bring her up to ride height. And you can see there's very little or no movement there. That's ride height right there. Now I'll bring her up to acceleration. And you can see it starting to tip in. That's 28 there. That's the total acceleration. So you can see the whole motion of movement there from one end to the other, and this is going the full distance. So there's not a lot there. I'm very pleased with it. From factory, these had 1¾ inches of bump steer. I covered that in the video I done on this, and I have, I think it's about 1⅜ inches of bump steer and throughout the entire travel area. So I'm very pleased with it. So now that I'm happy with it, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to button all this up and get all the springs and everything back in it and move on to another project. I got the springs put back in, I got the shocks put in, I went ahead, I got new calipers and pads and flex lines, I went ahead and installed all them. The rotors in good shape, there's just got to be the surface rust on them, I'm going to leave them be. So I got all the front end all put in, I got all the fittings figured out for the flex lines. I went ahead then and I made up a little bracket for the brake booster proportioning valve. I had to make this bracket so it bolted onto that. So I got that all set up. I got that all outfitted with the fittings that it needs. See what I needed. Of course, I got the other side done as well. So I got all that done now. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to run the front lines, because I got to run one across the firewall. I'm trying to get everything done back there that I can get done before it goes and gets the motor ready, because next after I get some brake lines done, I'm going to haul the motor out and start cleaning that up. So let's get making brake lines now. Look what I'm into. Running brake lines. Making this line now. This is not a bot line. Them little clips, I made them as well. You can buy them clips online and places. I make a lot of them. You can buy plastic ones local. They don't hold on strong enough, so I make these little ones. I'm going to show you in a minute how I make them. Well, it's pretty tricky making a line like this. All I concentrated on first was starting over here and running the line over and getting all the bends over here and getting it down through here. Okay, so then what I went and did is I had it running out through the fender. Here's where the fun begins. Now that I got it out here, I rolled it up in a small roll, like so, because I gotta run this down here now underneath here and come up and go around and into that. So it's a bit of fun. But when you roll up a small roll, like it comes in a big roll, but you roll it up small and you just turn around and then work it and then unroll it through here as you're coming across, and you should be able to get it. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna make up that line and I'm gonna show you them clips. So here's them lines on this side, all made up. And all it is, like I said, I just rolled it in underneath there and then bent it up, put the fittings on it. Now I'm gonna put a clamp on her here. I'll put a clamp on her there and put a clamp on her right here. And I'll do the same on the other side as well. Here's the other side, same thing. I made up that piece there, come out through there and I bent it down around. I'll put a clamp on her there and I'll put a clamp on her there. And that's how it'll be done. Let's go make them clamps now. There's everything you're gonna need to make some clips. This is usually what you can find. Like when you go local places, you usually find these style ones here that are just the, you got the rubber on them, you clamp them over. I find some very bulky looking. You can buy these ones locally, but you can only get them in a certain size. You can't get little small ones. Now you can buy abundance of these small plastic ones and get them in little small sizes and everything at Princess Auto. But I don't like that they're white. And I find that I've used them in the past, the small ones, and if there's any strain on a brake line whatsoever, they got a tendency to move on you and pull off the car, so they don't sit nice on the vehicle. So I kind of got in the habit of saying, well, I might as well try to make some, right? All I got here now is a piece of aluminum. You can use steel, whatever you like. You can paint them after the fact. You can get really fancy with them. I'm not getting fancy, really fancy with these. You can really detail these if you want to. But all I did here is I cut strips off on that piece of aluminum right here. I cut nice big long strips, longer than what they should be. One is wider than the other, but it's nothing fancy, okay? Now all I do is, like, you can use the brake line, a piece of brake line for it, but the problem I got with the brake line, when you start hammering over, you'll crush that over. All I use is a 3-inch nail, okay, for the piece. So I'll just lay this here, clamp it on. It's pretty simple. Like, all I've done is I cut the strips out with the grinder, use the grinder there. Now I'm just going to turn around and I'm going to clamp this on to me. I have them longer for the simple fact that you got to cut them off when they're done. So it's a lot easier when they're longer. If you try to make them the exact size, it gets complicated and they usually never comes out right. So you got to give yourself lots of excess. So all I'm using here is, I got an old key for a grinder, and I got a bit of tape over in there because of the straight edge on it. I'm using that as my hammer. I'm just rolling that over the top of that. I'm going to hammer that down into there like so. That's the extent of it. So this is what you're left with. This is what you got here. So you just pull it apart a small bit, pull the nail out. Here's what you're left with. Okay? Now I left it a little bit long, so now I can clamp it in the vise so I can drill a hole in it. You want to make the entire piece and drill it off before you cut everything off, because if you make it the exact size, if you want it that big there, if you make it that size and try to drill a hole in it, it's very hard to work with this. But I got all this excess here, so I got something to hold on to. So I'm going to go and I'm going to drill a hole in that now, and I'll show you. There you have it. Just a simple little clip. You can take that now. If you want to put a rivet in it, or put a screw in it, or a bolt in it, you can do it, right? Now, sometimes you can get pretty fancy with them. And like before you bend it over, you drill a hole right here. And then when you roll it over, you got two little strips. Just a little bit cosmetic. You can turn around. Now, this here got to be filed off and sanded off and dressed before it goes on. You could round out your edges and whatnot. But it's just a simple little hose clamp. For brake lines, or a brake line clamp, if you want to call it proper, for holding brake lines in place, and it works really well. Anyway, I got the brake lines run on the front of her here now. I got them all run out to the side. I still got to run them from the master cylinder down to the brake booster. And I got to run the main line out the back. I'm going to cut this one off here now because it's getting a bit long. So I'm going to go on. I'm going to finish off the brake lines and everything on this. And I'm going to get ready to get the motor ready to put in it. So in the next one, hopefully by the end of the next video, I'll have the engine and transmission mounted in this car. So that's it for this one. Hope the tips were good. And until next time.